What's up, everybody? It is a Blue Drake, and today I have another disgusting update for you. And yes, it is a super nasty update. Welcome to the next update on Project Ill. So, these guys have been regularly posting new footage of their project. Now, I know there's a lot of people who are concerned that there's no playable demo of this yet. I have actually been talking with the developers quite a bit since they originally premiered the game, and I have to say that right now, building out the first playable demo is their number one priority. Now, one thing I really want to make clear, all of these demos, these concept renders that they've been creating in Unreal Engine 4 are actually running in real time. So not only are these projects or these concepts being rendered in Unreal Engine 4 and created in Unreal Engine 4, but even more importantly, they are running in real time. And I've actually been shown this multiple times by the developers of the project. They've been walking me through the environments, they've been showing me all of the characters, they've been showing the demos and everything. And I mean, as you can see, at any given point in any of these demos that they're releasing, they can stop and move the camera around and it all runs very fluidly. I think this is something that a lot of people don't really understand about the game development process. Even though there is a lot of work to be done on actually creating the game logic, a lot of the work, a lot more than I think most people realize, is already done. So this is already all in engine. This is already all running in real time. It is optimized for a game environment. The animations are in, and the characters are developed. The environments are in. Like, as you guys can see, like, all of this environment art, all the trees, all the shrubbery, in addition to the characters themselves, like, it's in game and it's running and it seems to be running really, really well. So that's really, really exciting. So they've been releasing a whole bunch of new footage of new characters and new bosses. So these are all of the bosses that you were allegedly going to be fighting in the game. And I mean, it looks awesome. It looks like, I think the coolest thing that I like about Oleg's style, the lead developer who's working on this project, is that he kind of has this interesting blend between horror and comedy. Like, a lot of his stuff that he creates, yeah, it's horrible, it's terrifying, but at the same time, especially like this, like, it's also hilarious in very subtle ways. And I think that's something that's really, really unique to his style of art, you know, and his style of everything that he works in, from comic books to films to, you know, now video games. Like, a big underlying theme in all of his stuff is the humor aspect. And I think that's one of the things that I'm looking forward to most about this game. Like, I think one of my favorite movies of all time is The Cabin in the Woods, that was created by the same director who was behind the series Firefly. He actually created the movie Cabin in the Woods. I think it's called Cabin in the Woods. Is it not Night in the Woods? No, it's Cabin in the Woods, something like that. Anyways, and I think that was a really cool movie because it had all of these subtle blends of, like, comedy and also horror. And I feel like this is also where this is going. I think a lot of people have been comparing this to Resident Evil, and I think the difference between this project and something like Resident Evil is like 100% pure horror, where it's just, you know, terrifying and it's about, like, how things are grotesque. I think the coolest thing about the project Ill, and just to clarify, the project is not called Project Ill. I just call it Project Ill because the name is Ill and it is a project that is not completed. I don't feel comfortable calling it, like, the game Ill because it is not a 100% game yet. So that's why I call it Project Ill, because it is a project. But I think that's something that's really cool about Project Ill, is that it's not just horror, but it also has these elements of absurdism, where it's just, like, there's some situations where it's just goofy. Like, it's weird. It's, you can't look away. It's terrifying. It's horrifying. But it's also somewhat hilarious. Not all the time, but sometimes. You know, like, for instance, very specific. And I think that this recent demo is him kind of hinting at that. Because when this leech goes to this corpse and brings it alive, like, it's just funny. It's so, and I think that is really a reflection of the personality of the people creating this project. And I really hope that this project continues in that vein. Like, it's just this funny, horrifying thing. And I think that's what's so cool. So, I wanted to give you guys an update. There's been a lot of updates being released about this project, both on their Patreon and to the public. Usually everything they release on the Patreon, they also release for free to the public as well. I'm a member of the Patreon, so I see everything there, and I also see them just, you know, not immediately release it to the public afterwards, but they're not really paywalling anything. Like, they're showing everything that they're working on, and I think that it's really cool looking at a lot of the stuff that they've been uploading, showing, hey, look, this game, this project, all of our art, all of our stuff that we've been making in Unreal Engine, it's running in real time. Like, it is an Unreal Engine. All we need now is the people to put this together as far as the game logic is concerned. But yeah, I think that's really, really impressive. Now, one other thing I want to talk about is I don't feel like this is a game that's going to come out soon. I think a lot of people are currently in the state of mind. It's like, oh my gosh, this game's going to be finished. Now, we might have a demo, you know, as they continue working on the demo. Who knows? Maybe there will be a demo in the near future. But I think this is one of those games where, like, I would be okay with having this game take a while to be fully developed into a full-blown single-player project. You look at the time period that Scorn, the game Scorn, was first announced, and now, you know, it's been many years later, and they're going to be releasing on next-gen consoles and all that stuff, and they've taken this concept into a full-blown game. I have a feeling that this project has the potential to go along the same timeline. It would be nice if it didn't take as long as Scorn. But I want to make sure everybody realizes that. Like, this is not a game that's, like, coming out tomorrow. It would be cool if there's a playable demo at some point in the near future. I think that would be really, really cool. But I just want to make sure everybody realizes, like, this is not a project that I think should be rushed, especially since they're still in the process of recruiting developers and building a team. Yeah. So, anyways, really cool update. I really love seeing everything coming out about this game. Hopefully you do too. If you like seeing behind-the-scenes footage like this and in talking about everything related to the project, make sure you press that sub button or don't, you know, hey, whatever. And I'll see you guys in the next video. All right, take care. Remember, Blue Drake loves you, and eat your vegetables, okay? Eat your vegetables. Very important. As you get older, it becomes more important for you to have a healthy diet, okay? All right, kids? Okay, kids? This is important, okay? Remember this. All right, anyways, goodbye.